وأقول في القرآن ما جاءت به آياته فهو الكريم المنزال وأقول قال الله جل جلاله والمصطفى الهادي ولا أتأول
الحمد لله رب العالمين له الحمد الحسن والثناء الجميل وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له يقول الحق وهو يهدي السبيل وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه والتابعين لهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين أما بعد إنشاءالله تعالى I'm going to go into the second contradiction and in this contradiction إنشاءالله تعالى I want to speak about how people contradict themselves when it comes to the commandments of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala versus worldly issues. Let me expand on that. If one of us is informed and we're told Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He prohibited this thing, Allah made this haram, it is not allowed. We come to the person who's telling us, we say, what's your evidence in this issue? Why did Allah make it haram? What's the reason? Doesn't it seem a bit hard as a ruling? Do you think it's relevant right now? I don't want to hear that. All of those things. We argue. Al-jida' wal-mira'. It turns into a whole debate. We even say, "Akhi, this is all just hardship. It's just complicated. Akhi, just make the religion easy. Why are you telling the halal and haram? Ya akhi, please, ittaqillah." We start. The person just told us that it's halal, haram. We argue with the person, push the person back. On the flip side, we go to a doctor. The doctor prescribes a medicine for us. He tells us, this is the times that you need to take the medicine. And this particular tablets, you need to take it in the morning before breakfast. You need to take this much dose. This is this, this is that. And he gives you the other one. And he says, do this one in the evening. Make sure you don't take it more than once. There has to be this much hours in between each medication. وَهَلُمَّ جَرَّهُ You need to take it with an empty stomach, eat it before breakfast. وَهَكَذَا You don't say to the doctor, what are you talking about? Where did you get this from? Who preceded you from the doctors in this issue? You don't argue. You take it, you go back, you even ask the doctor to write it on a paper, or you ask him to write on the particular medicine, the box of the medicine. You don't argue. You accept it from him. And you listen and you adhere. Why is the religion of Allah not like that? Why don't we not submit to Allah's religion when we hear it straight away and take it and not argue about it? Did Allah not say, فَلَا وَرَبِّكَ لَا يُؤْمِنُونَ حَتَّى يُحَكِّمُكَ فِي مَا شَجَرَ بَيْنَهُمْ ثُمَّ لَا يَجِدُوا فِي أَنفُسِهِمْ حَرَجًا مِمَّا قَضَيْتُ وَيُسَلِّمُوا تَسْلِيمًا That they are not true believers. They are not true believers until they make you Muhammad their judgment. In any disputes and argumentations that happens between them, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, if they don't make you their judgments, and then once they've made you their judgment, the rulings that you pass and the judgments that you give Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, if they don't feel pleased with it and content and submit to it, then they're not true believers. Subhanallah. Also Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala, He says, وَمَا كَانَ لِمُؤْمِنٍ وَلَا مُؤْمِنَةٍ إِذَا قَضَى اللَّهُ وَرَسُولُ أَمْرًا أَنْ يَكُونَ لَهُمُ الْخِيرَةُ مِنْ أَمْرِهِمْ If Allah passes a judgment and His messenger passes a judgment, a believing male or female have no rights to question the laws and the regulations of Allah. No one has the rights to. What is upon us is to submit. We have no choice after Allah and His Messenger have passed the law. We have to submit. So this is a contradiction that many of us fall into. I'm going to stop there, inshallah ta'ala. Anything which I have said that was wrong or incorrect is from me and shaytan. And Allah and His Messenger are both free from it. Subhanaka Allahumma bihamdi, ashhadu an la ilaha illallah, astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayh.
Assalamu alaykum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu. How can you do a 2-second action right now that will give you a share of the reward of everything we're doing on this YouTube channel? Simple. Like this video and click subscribe. Why? It will allow YouTube to recommend our videos to other users. And imagine the huge amount of reward that could be waiting for you on the Day of Judgment if you did that with a sincere intention of spreading the Deen of Allah. You'll be rewarded for every single person who benefits from one of our videos as a result of your like or subscribe. That's an easy 2-second action that you definitely don't want to miss out on. Do it now, click like and subscribe, and don't forget to make that intention.